beautiful. That came out great. I'm gonna be adding like hunks like this. These ice cubes just kinda they melted and then refroze, so they're just all together like this. So when you're ready to add ice, just kinda lift it out slowly. And you just drop it back on. With an opening that size, you can put good-sized blocks of ice in there. Now the air coming out of there is freezing. You'd think you could add the ice in there. It looks big enough, but even the smaller cubes don't really fit that well through there. That's an advertised cube. It just won't fit. All right, let's take some temp measurements. This thing is working so good, it's unbelievable. I didn't expect it to work this good. Even lights up the inside all blue like that. That's gonna look so cool at night. Check that fan out. This one's got the drain, so you can drain out the water as needed. If you make your ice cubes with bottled water, definitely don't waste the water, just drink it. Put a glass under there. So now you can get a nice cold drink of water after a couple hours. Or you could hook a hose up there and just have it drain all the time so it's always just plain ice in there. That wire off to the left-hand side is just the hookup to the solar panel I got laying outside in the sun. That's the panel that's running it. Just comes in the door. And it's hooked up right there with the yellow and the green. Okay, there it is. It's working great. Alright, it's super easy to do. All I did was take this 80mm fan, laid it down on the side of the container like that, then I took my 1/3-inch dowel. You could use 1/4 inch, probably two. I cut two of them the width of the container. Again, holding the fan down, super glue one here and one there, and then two little ones on either side. Then take a pencil, mark around in a circle on the inside, and either take some scissors or a small kitchen knife and just cut out the circle. And that's where you'll add the ice. All right. End of this. I put it up against the container like that. Mark a small circle. I marked it on the inside so I wouldn't cut it too big. Originally, you're left with this. Then you just widen it out with a little bit of sandpaper until it fits. When it's the same size or just a little bit smaller, it'll just screw in and it'll tighten up. Just like that. And that's it. That's everything. Just want to give you a quick shot to show you that the fan is really in there. That fan's not going anywhere. And same with this. That just screws in. I think if you take just a little bit of care with this, it could last for years. Alright, it's all set. Should be able to just drop this stuff right in. Just slides out. Grab some pieces that look like they'll fit. That was a nice big piece. That was like 5 ice cubes at a time. Again, even one of these regular size ice cubes doesn't fit in the front, so I highly recommend making it like this. You can fit really big pieces and chunks in there. It's gonna take all that. That entire bowl is easily gonna fit in here. Alright, there it is. Now just drop the fan back on. Perfect. ton of airflow, smooth, quiet fan. I didn't think it was going to put out this much air. Just hooked to a solar panel right now. Wire comes in the door. It's right outside the door there. Alright, it's been like an hour. There's still a ton of ice in there. That's awesome. And you just drop it back on. This thing's working so good, it's unbelievable. And that fan, by the way, is only a 0.1 amp fan, 12 volt 0.1 amp or 100 milliamps. Just a quick rundown on the cost. The drink bottle itself was $1 at the dollar store. The PVC pipe about $1.50. The fan was $4.99 and the dowel was 98 cents. So what is that, about $8 or $8.50? That's if you have to buy everything.